Batty.
Morning, Gloria, love.
One thing, shan't have to scour me step in Australia.
Why not? You're not going to let yourself drift into monkey habits when you get there, are you?
They don't do it down there.
Well, scour the steps. Hello.
That face look familiar?
You silly devil.
Five in my own true love, Nora Batty.
Get back inside, you weird.
Nora, Mrs. Knight.
Hey up, Gloria, love. I just didn't have to inform me by your mouth.
It's got so that I ain't rattling my bucket. Every time he hears it, he's out pestering, talking filth.
It's true. And the sound of the bucket, my knees go weak, and me wellies start to palpitate.
There he goes, listen. Filth.
He's all right.
It's personal.
I'm full of passion.
Pull me off with this bucket.
Come fly with me, Nora. You and me, we could make magic together and I'd lay me buried to your feet.
You're not right. And don't you encourage him?
My only complaint is the legs.
You don't have any talk from men about my legs.
They're the ones drawing me vision of paradise. Some of my legs have all become stockings here like a tiny bandage. I must cost you a fortune to buy me creases in like that.
You're not even going to call me husband.
Well, you call him an old poor old lad. He bowed to me. It's cruel keeping things like him caged up inside.
To this outlandish place. It's exile. We've been banished.
They have given you your own library, Miss Probert.
Yes, full of tatty old men.
Oh, damn this date stamp.
Steady, Jones. You don't want people to think you're at a certain age or something. Now listen, I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll have a nice cup of tea, and then you can help me delete all these four-letter words in the new novels.
But that'll take forever.
Jones, somebody's got to do it. I want to go back to the children's library. We need it here, Jones.
I want to go back where Puss in Boots means just that. And that awful magazine.
I know, dear. I got a bit of a shaker too when I flipped through that thing about fairies.
What are we going to do?
We're going to stamp it out. We'll use a bit of psychology. We'll have one entire section labelled for degenerates and see who's got the nerve to browse through that. And as for these special orders, we'll fill in the postcard so it reads, "The filthy book you ordered is now ready for collection."
Gloria's going to Australia. Her next door. Be a nice lass. She's having a farewell party. We're invited.
What does he do?
He's a lorry driver.
Are they going for good?
They're emigrating.
Understandable. When you take into consideration who they've got for a neighbour.
Be anybody's first reaction? Australia.
It's a big step, leaving home.
It's a big place.
Only two up and two down.
Australia.
I wouldn't fancy summer at Christmas time. Although if we're going to have power cuts every year, I wouldn't mind it starting on Boxing Day.
The capital, of course, is Canberra.
Well, it's not that everybody knows.
I mean, some people do think it's Sydney.
And there's a lot of people think that of Sydney at all. With a tendency to be a bit fulsome in the gob department.
I have made some enemies, that is true. But one always does in the process of bettering oneself.
One always does in the process of bettering oneself.
Have you noticed how he always points his lips when he talks?
Oh, I had all this at school. Him and his cronies scuffing at my fair isle socks.
You were always a credit to your mum, Cyril. For us in our boots and jerseys, you in your little sandals helped us to understand that there were worse things even than the Depression.
Yeah, and he was a creeper.
Ah, but a very polished creeper, clean round the ear holes. Whereas you were rather more your lovable urchin of popular fiction, smiling through your grime as you went through his pockets for his milk money.
Oh, life a carefree for him. He never gave a thought to
boss who were burdened down with the responsibility of collecting all the pencils in. All he had to worry about was would Sheila Miller tell her dad?
And did she? No. We drifted apart anyway.
Oh, sad.
Nothing lasted in them days.
Especially my milk money.
I swapped her to Albert Mulgrew for a grass snake and two fags.
Oh, my God. And they say there's no romance left.
They've willow trees in Australia. I like a willow tree.
They've got plum trees.
Enough. He's a mine of information, this kid. You'll excuse us being surprised.
Oh, it's all right.
It's just that we were taught that you were thick.
I know.
Well, it must be just a mask you wear.
Oh, it is.
Like hell it is. Of course he's thick. That's the real him.
But he knows about gum trees.
And why shouldn't he? He's been up one all his life.
I wonder if I should go to Australia, you know, to try and get over Nora and Batty.
Well, you needn't feel lonely out there. If you want a bit of company, I expect her husband will come with you.
Why is he obsessed with Nora Batty?
Because she's there.
Well, I admit she's not pretty, but, well, it's her, you know, her personality.
Oh, yes, that is very appealing. Like jagged tin.
Very hard is Nora. But she turns my knees to jelly. What a Nazi she would have made, eh?
But just consider our Russian front. A man could freeze before he found any shelter there.
Well, maybe she'll thaw one day. Any case, I can always go to Australia.
Foreign Legion. That's what you want.
What?
French Foreign Legion. That's the classical place to go when you're disappointed in a woman.
I'm not joining up with any froggy mob.
Now, don't dismiss the idea without giving it a chance. We are trying to help you, aren't we? That's what friends are for, isn't it? Hey, oh, look at him backing away. He's going white, Luke. He's just like that down at the Labour when they're offering him a job.
I'm not joining up with the froggies.
Typical. You'd have every opportunity of dying gloriously and you won't even consider it.
I prefer Australia.
Ridiculous. Are you going to get killed out there, eh?
I don't want to get killed.
Oh, well, if I'm not going to talk to you, we're not going to consider it with an open mind.
It was just like this that time ago when we were spending hours trying to offer him to America for an astronaut.
They wouldn't have had me.
They sent monkeys up.
I give me a train.
Are you admitting that you are past training then?
No, but there's a limit how far I'll go for a bloody banana. Hey, talking to the froggies, that reminds me. Have you got a clean, white, untouched cigarette? It must be straight, not crumpled.
What for?
I will give you a demonstration of a left-handed Frenchman smokes a fag.
Come on then, let us see how a left-handed Frenchman smokes a cigarette. Oh, come on! How does a left-handed Frenchman smoke a cigarette?
The same as anybody else you'd got, Tilly.
What do you think you're doing, holy little men? Where do you think you are? Is this the way to behave in a library?
Shh! You are not supposed to raise your voice in here.
I wouldn't be seen dead with a profile like that.
Suppose you get used to it, if you're lucky.
Well, what have they ever done for humanity except run off and make war on dubious women in foreign parts? And we all know which parts.
It can't be all bad.
Every single one of them. Have you ever known one who hadn't got that terrible compulsion to peer up ladies' garments? Well, why do you think spectacles were invented? Not to mention the telescope. Do you really imagine that Galileo was sent to prison because his theories about the sun? Rubbish. Bet it was his new view of somebody's missus that got him popped in the chokey.
They discovered penicillin.
Yes. But only recently. They'd have found it a million years ago if it'd been up some female's jumper.
Trackers. They could go for days without water.
So could you. Ah, but they've not been swilling pale ale.
Funny names they have in Australia.
Frank Highfield.
Highfield? Wallaroo. Martina.
It's not worse than Ekman Dwight.
At least in Ekman Dwight, the Matildas aren't forever waltzing.
Ah, well, they've not got a jambook up their billabong.
Parlour bears are smooth to touch.
They've got bloody noses. Yours isn't exactly noble Roman, is it?
The man bent it.
Here he is, it's the Pied Piper.
How do?
They hit the pole.
Necessary work, escorting little children across today's road.
Is all swine?
Look at him, you wouldn't think he was once known as Dreamboat at the Mecca Locana.
I remember the new pointed toe shoes and his hair all plastered down. Yeah, what about that suit?
What about they? My hair might have been plastered, but that was plastered right through.
Oh, yeah, but I had learned how to drink properly then.
Well, now that is accomplished, perhaps you will learn how to pay for them.
When I'm flush, it drinks all round. When I'm not, I expect me mates to show a bit of generosity.
Showing generosity is one thing, but showing what you're showing is quite another. Get yourself fastened up. More holes than a dot house blanket.
Cheer up, Jack. You never know, they might bring back the foxtrot.
Went all through last while. 5.5 years on it, and I can't say as I ever ate it, Jerris. But I've been 6 months a lollipop man, and I could cheerfully strangle every little brat under 18.
You want me mad wanting to strangle poor little innocent kids? Use your pole, what do you think it's for?
The young are a great comfort as you grow older. Makes you realise that at least you're going in the right direction.
Look at this, 1932, I got that. WS, William Shimonite, equals AD. Oh, yeah, we're AD.
Must have been a love affair of classic proportions. Can't even remember her name.
No, must have been a new penknife. You always had a tendency to push it and start carving in them, didn't you? AD.
Albert Drury.
Watch it.
It'd have been Aggie Duckett.
Something, mate. Just a because I laughed at her dad's boots. I mean, how the hell was I to know she were wearing them? What an ugly couple they were.
I could have been a musical, Fred Astaire and Ginger Rogers.
He always had scabby knees.
Can't give his mind up a leg, sassies.
Always tripping over them bloody boots. She were a fanatic of marbles.
Oh, hello.
So that's how it started, eh? In a frenzy of emotion, she snatched his marbles.
Shut up! He doesn't look well, does he? He doesn't look well.
Oh, never mind about me. Tell him where we've come.
Oh, I thought it were a pilgrimage. The place where you first plighted your troth to Aggie Duckett.
We've come about that piano.
Have you still got your Eileen's piano?
Ah, it's been touched since she were with. Job I got nothing to sing about.
Hey, can we have a little bit Saturday night?
I take it it's still there.
We're having a bit of a do at six, Cap.
Aye, farewell, party. Young couple immigrating.
A twinkle fingers here gets moody if he can't perform.
I have no wish to intrude. Just a few of the old tunes, you know. Try me porting a little in his spare time. Well,
save it now. Don't get your talent in a twist.
Now come along, Cyril, come along. You're under a moral obligation to perform. Your man paid for all them piano lessons, and besides, we all understand how much pleasure it gives you.
And in any case, I shall need you to accompany me when I perform on the comb and paper.
Well, if you insist.
Oh, we do. That poor lass needs some encouragement to go to Australia.
Come on, Camille. Get me out for dinner. That damn great fuss will be there in 2 minutes, and if I'm not there, they'll have it over. It's not that I don't like kids. I just can't stand them.
You're just a victim, really, of the battered parent syndrome.
Hey, what about the tinkle of children's laughter? Doesn't that mean anything to them?
Ah, it means they've just broken something.
Not enough discipline, that's the trouble. Oh, blimey, Elsie's off again. For goodness sake, sit down and stop yawping about. You've got more rattle than Aunt Reeves, Laurie.
Hey, proper miserable, ain't you? For a pianist.
Still, when we get the piano on.
Hey, what's the game? Come on, you lazy devil. You pull it then.
I told you they'd bring back my foxtrot.
He's nothing. If we were employing him, he'd want 6 months on the sick and £400 damages for that loss.
£450.
doesn't look well, does he? He doesn't look well.
Thank you. Next, though,